and welcome back to GolfChallengeTV.com. I'm Luis Mendoza. This is actually part two to the hydrostatic body fat test that I did with Linda Findley. After the test, I sat down with Linda and we went through the report in more detail so she could explain to us all the measurements and exactly what they mean and how they can help us understand our body a little bit better. So if you have any questions, shoot them to me here in this blog, leave me some comments. You can also call Linda at the information below, and I will also be posting some of these charts on this report so you have a good reference of what these numbers mean. Okay, so until next time, I'm Luis Mendoza, GolfChallengeTV.com. See you soon.
Okay, we're here with Linda again, and we just finished doing the testing. And I just kind of want to go over through the report, and you can explain to me a little bit of what this is. Let's go ahead.
So each person gets a four-page analysis report. And basically it's on, personal information. But in particular, we keep a history, so every time somebody does a test, you'll see all your past results.
Right.
So the date, your total weight, your lean mass, fat mass, and body fat percentage, okay?
Gotcha.
Lean mass is basically all your metabolic tissue. So it includes not only your muscle, but your bones and organs, okay?
Right, and that's why we have to let all the air out.
That's
so,
right.
So we can
That's
get
right.
That
well,
reading.
Air equals fat, okay? So the more air you get out, the better. And it's my job as a technician to get you to go to the end of your breath, okay?
Gotcha.
Now, the second page is a chart. The women have a separate chart. The men have their own chart.
Okay.
And along the top, you'll see age groups. And essentially on the columns, you'll see not very good to essential, which essential means you need that amount of fat, okay?
Just to be alive.
That's right.
To function properly.
That's right. That's right. Now, you happen to fall in a very healthy range.
Mm-hmm.
You're at... 10.6%, which is in top shape for a man who's between 30 and 39.
Excellent.
Now, page three is essentially another little chart where we did the math for you,
okay,
in case you wanted to fine-tune and drop a little bit of fat. Most of America needs to lose fat, but not really their muscle. Okay?
Right, so you can literally lose fat, but not lose so much weight.
That's right. The idea is that we don't lose just technical weight. We lose weight specific, which would be
sure.
fat.
Got
okay?
It, got it.
We need all of our muscle. We need our muscle to not only function, but
sure.
we need to feed ourselves enough food to fuel that muscle function.
Got it,
okay?
Got it.
So, but if you want to say drop into the single digits, like
yes.
7 or 8%, doing the math here, you'd have to drop between 4.5% and 6%, or 6 pounds, sorry,
6 pounds, right.
4 to 6 pounds of fat to drop down to 7 or 8%.
Now, let me ask you a question directly to this. My goal really is, I haven't weighed 156 pounds since my high school days, and the highest I've ever weighed was 175.
Okay.
But that was, I was weightlifting excessively, and I was every day in the gym.
Right.
So it was a lot of muscle that
right.
was there. But I would like to get up to, gain another maybe 10 pounds where I feel just healthier.
Yeah.
Right now I'm very, very thin. I'm very skinny for me
yeah.
That I feel. So I can still gain those 10 pounds getting back in the gym and maintain that 10% body
fat.
Okay,
so you're going to gain muscle and fat too.
Oh, okay.
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 If you gained only muscle, which is hard to do. In a good way.
Okay.
If you gain only muscle, it's tough to gain 10 pounds of straight muscle.
Right.
You're gonna gain some fat with that. Because you have to eat more calories, right?
Definitely, yeah.
Okay, so it's calories in, calories out, but to gain muscle, you have to eat more. So
I expect in the retest, once I accomplish this, my body percent fat will go up.
Well, it could stay the same, but you would gain, respectively, a certain amount of muscle, a certain amount of fat to stay at that percentage.
Right. Gotcha, okay.
Right.
Got it.
So if you gain a little bit of fat with that and gain like 8 pounds, like say you over time you gain 10 total pounds, but 8 of it is muscle and 2 pounds is fat. So
got
your the percentage is a bigger ratio, so
yeah,
your percentage
yeah.
is going to be less, right?
Correct.
Okay. So, over time, you jump back in 3 or 4 months, make sure you're on the right track. If you're gaining weight, you want to make sure you're gaining the right weight. For most of America, we need to lose weight.
This is the wrong weight that we have.
That's right, but we want to jump in to see that we're losing the right weight, which is fat weight, right?
Yeah.
And gaining muscle. Women are typically under muscle. Men usually have great muscle mass because they eat high fat proteins. Women, and this is just
burgers.
Trends. That's right. That's the red meat stuff.
That's the
right?
red meat, right.
That's right. So, and I see these trends with everybody that comes in. I can figure out their habits and.
Right. So there's really no hiding behind these tests.
You pretty
much know what their living habits are. And
here's what's interesting. Just overall, the hundreds and hundreds of tests that I've done, and I can tell who skips meals.
Really?
Like they eat once or twice a day. Or just three times a day, like the three staples.
Yeah.
But it's too far between meals, so their metabolism is slow. They're typically higher body fat percentage than you'd think. They might fall into that category of the skinny fat people.
And I imagine that's more of a women habit.
It is, but I have men who do it too. You know, they eat two giant meals, you know, because they go so,
yes.
right?
I've been doing
well,
that.
Well, and who wouldn't if you starve yourself all day? You're starving.
Yeah. Then you just want to fill it with carbs.
That's
right. You just want
to
eat.
Well, it happens to be the first thing that enters, right? It's like, ooh, there's the bread, or ooh, there's the chips, right? So, you know, if you can get, my leanest people eat 6 and 7 times a day, right?
Absolutely.
That's right.
No,
and
absolutely. That's,
the
that's
first
great.
Thing that enters is usually protein on my leanest people. They're always thinking, which protein am I going to go for?
Yeah.
Chicken, fish, tuna,
whey, right.
egg whites. What is it going to be? But they're always surrounded with it. They don't go anywhere without it.
So they never starve the body, and the metabolism is always working. Because they're eating 6, 7 times a day.
That's right. Well, and you couldn't pay them to skip a meal.
Right.
You know, and our society, we're always thinking, I need to drop some weight. And I think I'll just skip this meal for now. And what you're actually doing is feeding the fat. You can borrow that.
We're feeding the fat people. So
when you skip meals, you feed your fat.
Yeah.
That's really what happens.